Good morning, everybody. All right, today we are talking about follow-up. So important. I'm sure you've heard the saying, the fortune is in the follow-up, and it couldn't be more true. I have people that I have followed up with 1 to 2 times that have joined me in this process. But I would say the majority of the people that I have gotten to join me with Plexus, it is taking me, I would say, on average, 4 to 5 different contacts. There are some people that I have talked to 15 times for the past 4 months, and they still haven't joined me. But you know what? I know that they're going to eventually join me. Every time I talk to them, they say, I need these products so badly. I know they want to do it. I just need to find a way to get them to push the button. I've tried deals, I've tried everything to get them off the fence. So I know it's just going to take a little bit of time. They're still watching, they're still interested. But I keep following up and I try not to be annoying. I just follow up every once in a while if I have a special or to see if they have any questions or, what's holding them back. They don't believe in it yet. They haven't experienced the pink drink like I have. They don't know what they think they know what it could be like, but they don't know if it's for real. And they hope for it. And I just need them to try it. And so you gotta just keep following up. I know if I don't follow up that it just goes to the back of their mind, and maybe they think about it here and there, but they aren't excited enough to push the button and try it. So I need to keep following up with them and keep contacting them and just say, hey, I saw your picture this last week of you and the girls in Oklahoma. Gosh, it looked like a fun time. You guys are all so cute. Have you thought any more about Plexus? You popped into my head when I saw that picture and thought I'd follow up real quick. And see where they're at on things. Maybe they have a few more reservations that you just haven't quite touched on. Maybe it was financial reasons and they were just waiting for some money. So keep following up, because if you don't, I guarantee you their interest is going to continue to be piqued. And unfortunately and fortunately, there are a lot of people that are joining this business. So there's going to be more and more people that are going to be sharing Plexus on their Facebook news feed, and you may lose them to somebody else. So fortune is in the follow-up. Something I just read in the I just finished reading GoPro, which is a really, really great book. I suggest all of you read it if you have time. It's not too long. And really, really great points. But he was saying how you need to emotionally disconnect yourself from the outcome. Our initial goal with these potentials is about education and getting them to understand what the products can do for them. Our goal isn't to get a new customer and a new ambassador. We love these products. We know these products are working for so many people, and we really want to help our friends. It's not about making a sale. And I know you guys know that, but maybe our friends don't. Maybe they feel like you're just trying to push the next best thing onto them, and they don't really buy into it. So you need to focus on educating them and helping them understand. If you can disconnect your emotions from the outcome of that and just focus on educating them and helping them understand what these products are, everything is going to get a lot more simple for you, and you won't take those no's so personally. We are just offering suggestions on how people can live a better life. We're a consultant for them. So be yourself and bring passion about the products and the company when you're talking to people. So another thing I learned was the only reason for following up is to set up another exposure. So we need to keep setting up exposure after exposure. The goal needs to change from getting that prospect on that first exposure when you send them the information. We need to keep the process alive. And so by setting up the next exposure and the next exposure until they've made a decision, then we won't know what their decision is if we don't keep setting up that next time. So I'm going to post some suggestions in my comments that I have for follow-up and some different things you can take away. It's from our success guide, and it just has the initial follow-up, a second contact, a third contact, and then people who say no, not for right now. Just ways to follow up with them and keeping them in your planner, which is another thing I wanted to touch on that I forgot to write down. But I think it's really important once you start getting a lot of leads to not lose them or forget that you talk to them. And so I use a planner just to kind of keep myself on schedule. So if I talk to them on like a Thursday, I may put it in for next week to make sure that I'm following up so I don't forget. And then if they still are kind of on the fence, maybe put it out 2 weeks. Or the closer you can keep those exposures, I think the better, because people will lose interest over time. Like if you're going a month at a time and don't follow up with them for another month, I think at first keep those exposures really close together. People want to know that you're interested in them, but don't be too pushy. I think there's a fine line, and you just have to find that with each individual person too. So we need to, let's see, it takes an average of 4 to 6 exposures for somebody to join you. I think that's really a crazy statistic, and I have a few more to share with you just to really wrap your mind around how important follow-up is. But 48% of salespeople never follow up after the first exposure. Never. They don't ever check back in to see what they're thinking. 25% of salespeople make a second attempt and then they stop. They don't follow up again after that. 12% make 3 attempts and then they stop. 12% of salespeople only make 3 attempts, and only 10% make more than 3. That is just crazy to me. So the other side of those sales statistics are the actual sales. So 2% of sales are made on the first contact. Only 2%. And I will say that that is very true for my business. I maybe even less than that of the people who have actually joined me on the first contact. 3% on the second contact, 5% on the third contact, and only 10% on the fourth. So guess where the rest of those 80% of sales come from? They're made on the fifth through the 12th contact. Those statistics are amazing. So that is why the fortune is in the follow-up. You have to keep getting those exposures out there. You have to keep following up. Keep posting. Make your posts geared towards those people that you have on your dream list that you know the issues that they're kind of dealing with. So make some Facebook posts just to help inform them with your Facebook posts, even if it isn't just actual messages. They're reading your posts. So go from exposure to exposure, knowing that it's going to eventually sink in. You're also going to build a stronger relationship with those people by following up, and you're going to strengthen your friendship with those people in the process. So, that's all I have for follow-up. I think it's really, really, really important. I hope you all watched my short video yesterday about our event that we're going to be having with Jacqueline. I also want to talk quickly about a little strategy I learned in that GoPro book too, and I've heard it from Jacqueline and a few other people, but it's called If I Would You. So you want to say to your potentials, if I invited you to our special Zoom meeting next week with a few of my friends, would you attend? So you're asking them a question and you're expecting an answer, and hopefully you get a truthful answer, and you can kind of see where they're at on things and feel them out and make them feel comfortable with this Zoom event, that it's not going to be scary or intimidating, or they're going to be put on the spot. Like they can even just call in to that Zoom call. They don't even have to have the live video if they don't want to. They can call in and be a fly on the wall. But you just want to know that they were there. So number one thing about doing the if I would you is it's reciprocal. So you're saying that you will do something for them if they will do something for you. So you will attend with them. It's just for them. We've set up this special meeting for them, and we'd love for them to attend in return. So secondly, you're in control and you're not begging them to attend. You're not saying, "Oh, I would really, really love it if you would join me." And thirdly, it implies that you have something special and a value for them to learn from. Like, this is just for them. It's exciting. We want them to learn more about our products, and we're so excited to share with them. In the beginning, I said things like, "I really, really, really want you to watch this video," or "I really want you to try my product." It shows a little bit of weakness and a little bit of desperation, in my opinion. And I quickly learned from that I needed to be bolder. I needed to be confident. show them that, you know, this event and our products in general are something to be excited about, and that you are feeling so great and your friends and family are feeling so great. And this isn't about, you know, pushing the next best product. It's not a magic pill. Like, this is really a lifestyle and a way to feel better, and it's exciting. So we are really excited about this private event that we're having for you guys next week. And I hope that we can get at least a handful of potentials on there, because I know what a difference those live events made for me when I was making a decision on the product. And I also know what a difference it made for me when I talked to Jacqueline about the business opportunity. That is what put everything in perspective, and I realized that the opportunity was there for anybody who wanted to take it, and that these products were like nothing I'd ever seen before. And I was It excited me. It excited me. And so I hope it does for you guys too. I'm really excited about the Silver and Seven Challenge. You guys are doing amazing. We've got a couple ambassadors signed up already. You guys are getting new customers. So I'm just really excited. Reach out to Carrie and I with any questions that you have or any help that you need. We are here for you. So I hope you guys have a great Sunday. It is a beautiful day outside.